Hi, I'm Heinbach, and it's good to have you back. In my music, I enjoy the element of low fidelity recordings, short lo-fi. For example, something recorded on a dictaphone such as this gets a magical texture to me because you can hear the medium struggling to play the music. And you can glitch out the recording, and there's something special when you hear the texture of the machine. I went as far as releasing an album on microcassette, which is probably the most lo-fi medium you can record to next to a wax cylinder. Lo-fi has a special place in my heart, but not only mine. Filmmaker Julian Moser took my album Light Splitting, which is now available finally on vinyl also in the States, and created a whole movie out of it. It premiered on Fact Magazine and then went on to the Ars Electronica Festival. And now it's here in the end of this video. Julian Moser took the lo-fi approach that I used in some of the tracks on this album and translated it to visuals. And he employed a technique that if you are a long-time viewer of this channel, you might recognize.
My name is Julian Moser. I'm a filmmaker and director of photography, and I want to talk about my approach to the visual album to Heinbach's Light Splitting. Back in spring, during lockdown, Heinbach asked me to create a visual part for his upcoming release. We had collaborated before, when back in 2016 I asked Heinbach to create a soundtrack for me and my brother's short documentary War of Brothers. I pitched him an idea to shoot on mini DV and play it back at half speed, and it didn't take more convincing from this point on. I started out very simple, by shooting reflections in a hallway. But soon after, I became frustrated with the static shots and the restrictions of the lockdown, so I got on my bike and shot at different locations out in nature, but grew even more impatient with the footage. But I also had no idea what to do. One morning, I couldn't go back to sleep, so I got up at 5 a.m. As I was sitting in my kitchen, I saw the light of the morning sun flickering through the birch tree in the backyard. It might sound like a cliché, but the shadows of the leaves were dancing on my fridge, and the little plant farm looked so beautiful that I had to shoot it right away. This is the mini DV camcorder that I'm using. It's a Median 9021, which is basically a rebranded version of a Samsung VP-D55. It has a built-in macro lens that you normally use with a wide or teleconverter. So if you don't use it with any sort of converter, you have a macro mini DV camcorder with a 20x optical zoom. The lens has beautiful chromatic aberration, which is normally considered to be a sign of inferiority. This is further amplified by the glass, which serves as an optical prism and refracts the light. A zoom then leaves you essentially with just the chromatic aberration and the refracted light. The manual focus button doesn't work anymore, and in autofocus mode, you have a constant hunt for focus, which creates a wobbly underwater feel. I also found out that by giving the water inside the glass just the right amount of spin, the floating particles were further creating refractions of the light. Now, this is not something that I had ever thought about while I was writing the concept for this visual album. It is rather a happy accident, which luckily came about at just the right time.
Thank you.
divides nation from nation, race from race, class from class. Father, forgive. The covetous desires of people and nations to possess what is not their own. Father, forgive. The greed, which exploits the work of human hands and lays waste the earth. Father, forgive. Our envy of the welfare and happiness of others. Father, forgive. Our indifference to the plight of the imprisoned, the homeless, the refugee. Father, forgive. The lust, which dishonors the bodies of men, women, and children. Father, forgive. The pride, which leads us to trust in ourselves and not in God. Father, forgive. Thank you.
Thank you.